So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Southeast Missouri State Redhawks and the Alabama Crimson Tide.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Crimson Tide should be able to run away with this one, Dick Vitale.
Hey, what are the keys for them doing so? The keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, the point guard has to take control of the game, and he has to dictate the tempo and the pace. Second of all, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. Thirdly, don't be passive defensively. Be the initiator and force them to do things they don't want to do offensively.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Both teams looking to get things going here. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler and he lost it.
Way outside. Nice shot. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block with a long bomb. He'll regroup the offense. They work the perimeter. And his shot rejected. Here they come now on a turnover. Tries for two. Up and in.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Fed the low block. There's the fake. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Beasley is feeling good.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Inside. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. From left of the circle, they're dialing threes up like nothing right now.
Hey, this is awesome to watch, baby.
The shooting guard handles the feed. He pulls the trigger. On the outside, the power forward receives the pass. And up and sinks the shot. There's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Working it around the perimeter. And, Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
He fires from long range. Goes.
They scored seven in a row.
Going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gotta eliminate those turnovers.
The shooting guard handles the pass. That was nice.
That's basic.
On the outside. Steals the ball. Fast break opportunity here. Looking for contact.
Dump it inside.
Goes up for two. perfectly executed. Trying to pack it inside. Unloads. Sinks the shot. The center receives the ball. Here's the offensive drop step on a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Looking for a good shot. He puts up the tray. Oh, yes. The skip pass is picked off. Inside. And now they'll bring it up.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
Time to pick up the defense here now.
Ah, poor job. Poor job offensively. If I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball in the deck. Where's he going?
Puts it up, looking for contact. From the top of the circle, Rivers buries the tray. He tries the three. Alabama are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense. Oh, what a strip, Rad. Take a look right here. Nobody steps into the driving lane. He allows him to get the crease, the lane, the angle.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Just too slow to stay with his man, Dick, and he picks up the foul.
Well, two mistakes. Number one, he lets him get the ball in that deep. And number two, he doesn't have any footwork and doesn't move and beat him to the spot.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
That's a foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the first. Two at the charity stripe.
That's a 7-0 run.
Working around the perimeter. He wants a three.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
Takes the pass in the paint. Controlling the ball. Gave it up. He launches a three. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad. See who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Oh, 2. Drains it.
They scored 12 in a row.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He draws a foul. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick down on the sidelines. The losing team is starting to get a bit anxious. Their coaches can sense that, and they're telling their team to just relax. Could it be the bright lights that have this team second-guessing so far tonight, Brad?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Alabama have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
And they get the turnover.
Up and inside.
He tries to knock down the three. Off the rim and no good. Gets it to fall. Come with a double team to stop it.
Steele go up the other way, get a layup. I say they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little Pipsy Dude Dunkaroo.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish close position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Got some room.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
These boys are tearing it up behind the arc right now, Dick.
They've got them at their mercy with the threes, Brad.
Try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
On the dribble, gives it up. Boy, terrible execution on offense. For the bucket, they just can't seem to miss.
They found a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. He gets that one to fall. They work the perimeter. Tries for two. This one looks to be headed for a blowout.
Someone better step up in a hurry, baby.
Dickie really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Intercepted. On the inside.
They're pushing that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
He tries the three ball. He drains the shot. Goes for three. You betcha.
How about a replay, boys? Turnover City now always nearing the gate. Any offense?
There's a slam. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I'll tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
This defense simply swarms the ball, and they cause a five-second violation. So they'll inbound on the near sideline. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Gave it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
It rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
Defensively down a low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Work it around the arc. Stolen away. And the ball goes out of play. Oh, he's having fun with the opponent's stick.
He sure is, but he better make sure that he doesn't cross the line.
And a momentary look from three-point land on the outside. He shoots from long range. Way off target. Up! Easy one! He unloads a three. Off the rim and no good. Basket falls despite the contact. There's a double team waiting there. And back they come the other way. For two, makes it. Here's a double team. Trying to draw some contact. Alabama are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Moving it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown.
Screen was there, but the shot didn't fall.
He hits a bullseye again.
And he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
Going to move it around the perimeter. He takes it away. Fast break possibility coming.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
Count that as a personal foul. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnovers.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor.
He's good for another score.
Hands in his face anytime now, boys.
Stolen away. It's a fast break possibility. Buries it home. On the outside. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Mm-hmm. bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
The ball goes out of bounds. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Working around the perimeter. He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Entry pass in the paint. He uses the shot fake.
Pressure that basketball.
Takes it off him. Tries for two. They are heating up this building where they're shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Good job defensively. And a slam. They work the perimeter on the dribble, gives it up, goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. And he scores despite the hack.
Spacing.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Great screen set up, but the shot won't go.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Fakes the shot.
Set that screen away. Double team now. Bad angle.
Two, 10 on the shot clock. Picked off. Shot clock is dead.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Picked out of the air. Cross court. He shoots from right of the circle. He hits it from way downtown. Time, the Red Hawks are trailing by 38. We've had a good battle so far, Dick. What do you have queued up for our highlight of the half?
Hey, Brad, when you look back at the first half, you have to consider this three ball, which set the tone for how the first half was going to go.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Alabama had an awesome first half shooting the ball, Dick. Can we expect more of that in the second half, you think?
Hey, with the composure they're showing on the floor, Brad, I wouldn't doubt it. This is a very methodical team.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. With the shot, he comes up empty. Oh, my, he ran into a major league screen that time. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. That one goes back from whence it came. Kicks it out. The small forward with the ball. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. Way off target. For two, gets the rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
He's got to move the ball. And we've got a whistle and a foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I think, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
It rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
There was no doubt about that one. Picks off the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. Takes the pass in the paint. Goes up for two for the deuce.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
To get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
It's stolen. They push it up on the break. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing the ball.
The power forward gets the pass.
Excellent spacing, that's so important with a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. He fouled him. Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I'll tell you one thing. Coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose air and you get balled like I am.
High post player flashing. Intercepted.
He brought the ball back down to the floor and he stripped him.
Great shot. Working it around the perimeter. They're working around the arc. Jumps in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Picks off the lazy pass. High post flashes for the ball handler. Goes up for two. It sticks. Steal. Defense got it after knocking it loose. Was that beautiful or what? Moving it around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. Trying to draw the foul. He gets the board. Picks off the pass. On the outside.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Up fake. Tries to get the D to bite. For the bucket.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
And a momentary look from three-point land. The shooting guard gets the ball. Outside jumper gets it to go. tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Now they work it around the perimeter. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
The point guard takes the feed. Fake. And all the way on the baseline. Now the kick out on the outside. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Up it inside.
He intercepts it. On the dribble, gives it up. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back.
There's the trap.
Three goes. From the top of the key, rims out. Steals the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For two. Off the rim and no good. Number 34 with the fake. Goes up for two.
I tell you, that's a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
Intercepted.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He lets it go. They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous.
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
I can't believe there wasn't a whistle on that one.
Yeah, it should have been a whistle right there. I thought there was definitely an offensive charge.
He launches the bomb. He buries it. There's the pick. He throws it up from downtown. It's no good. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job on the defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
On the inside. There they come with a double team to stop it. He shoots from the baseline. Whatever's left in the tank needs to be used, Dick, and it needs to be used right now. Takes it off him. Change in possession. The defense knocked it loose, then went and got it. Looking for a good shot.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the crowd certainly hoped for a closer matchup. One side of the arena is celebrating in the stands, and the other one is just sitting there in complete disbelief, guys.
inside.
For the deuce. Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
Hey, they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
Gave it up. Good defensive stance there. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
As we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
The Pistons are firing on all cylinders right now.
This is a well-oiled machine right now.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out. Dump it inside.
The shooting guard takes the pass. For the bucket. He nails the bucket. The Crimson Tide are up by 42. On the outside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He fires it up. Tickles the twine. He launches the bomb. He gets the shot to fall.
Looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He puts it in with contact and all. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important, get 15 to 17 feet apart.
There's a double team waiting there. Looking for the foul. Gets it to fall. The Redhawks are behind by 43.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
Shoots it. Great shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Here's a double team. He dials long distance. He drains the bucket. Working it around the perimeter. The ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Jumped in front to take it away. Working around the perimeter.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Alabama have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
Pump fakes.
Double team now, bad angle. Up and inside.
Definitely a foul. Full house. And a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Tries for two. Pull-up jumper from way out. Sinks it. Thinks about the shot. He shoots from the top of the circle. Misses on the trifecta. Now they work it around the perimeter. Leans in. Drops the bucket despite the harm. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Nothing but joy and delight in the stands right now. These fans realize that this game is out of reach, Dick.
Well, it's simple. They came out, executed a game plan, and ended up on top.
Fakes a jumper. For two. Up. Easy one. Perimeter. He tries the three. Buried it.
Up and inside.
He takes the three and he misses the shot. Looking for a good shot. Jumped in front to take it away. Length of the floor. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important to 15 to 17 feet apart. There's the trap.
He launches a three. That's an ill-advised shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Easy one. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it from where you are, but I can hear it clearly. The coach is stressing to his team, go inside, go inside. They've been effective in this area all night long. What an asset to have.
All right, thanks, Erin.
I'll tell you, Erin's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
They work the perimeter. He shoots from right of the circle. For the deuce, lays it in. He shoots from the top of the key. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Nice shot. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure on the basketball. Up and inside. Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
He tries the three ball. He drains it.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Jumps into the defender. This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
He intercepts it. For the bucket. Perfectly executed.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
Stolen away.
The offense is having a hard time finding the open look.
Great defense. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He shoots from the top of the key. He nails the bucket.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well. Look at that spacing.
He shoots from the top of the key. He gets the bucket to fall. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He goes for three. He hits it. Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you've got to win it, keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I'll tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
The Crimson Tide played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nestler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
Brad Nestler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.